if a picture's worth 1,000 words, a movie's worth 1,000,000 words. When you see things on a temporal scale, you're going past or beyond the snapshots, and we're starting to catch biological phenomenon that we only really dreamt about before. And now we're actually seeing it happening in real time. In many cases, biological processes or phenomena happen at very fast time scales. When you're taking still images, you might miss these time scales or miss these events, essentially. Taking them in real time allows you to capture more detail and really understand what's happening within a cell. When we want to capture or we want to study something in real time, we want to ask ourselves whether it's inside the cells or between cells, we're really looking at movement. What are the movements that characterize important cellular functions, whether we're talking about division or we're talking about the resistance of an organism to a drug? By looking at the cell in real time, we can actually pinpoint, understand the mechanisms of what the reaction might be to the environment or to specific chemicals. Biology isn't static. Still pictures give us a snapshot of what we're looking at, but again, if a picture is worth 1,000 words, a movie's worth 1,000,000 words, and we can really understand more as we look down that temporal time scale to understand what's happening within the cell. When we get these beautiful images, we want to communicate these beautiful images to not just the scientific audience, but to the lay audience as well. I spend a lot of time with my group in terms of composition. We make figures from these images for publication, for posters, for presentations. And you know, you want to match the beauty of these images with a nice representation. So it really informs how we put this information out there and how we convey this information to the public.